Good evening. It was a once-in-a-lifetime celebration of the Queen's 70-year reign. And while Her Majesty wasn't able to attend her own party, she still stole the show with a heartwarming sketch. The world's biggest stars performed under a stunning light display at Buckingham Palace as her son and future king delivered a deeply personal tribute. Ellie Walsh begins our coverage.
To celebrate a record-breaking reign. First on stage, who else but Queen? Prince Charles and Camilla, William and Kate, and two of the Cambridge children had taken their seats in the royal box. Tens of thousands had packed the Mall, and inside Buckingham Palace, a tea party for two.
Thank you for having me. I do hope you're having a lovely jubilee.
Tea?
Oh, yes, please.
This was the woman they all wanted to see, Her Majesty in a skit with another British icon.
Perhaps you would like a marmalade sandwich. I always keep one for emergencies.
So do I. I keep mine in here.
Paddington Bear speaking for everyone.
Thank you for everything.
A monarch still in charge of the show. Which quickly became a roll call of some of the world's biggest acts. Little Prince proving he was up with the classics. The famous Royal Avenue leading up to the palace full of people, a sea of flags in red, white and blue.
With 10,000 people receiving free tickets and a public ballot watching from the stands, tens of thousands more have packed the Mall and surrounding parks. Out here, the tickets were free. Everyone was invited to party. What does it feel like to be here?
It's amazing, yeah.
Singers and performers from an international fraternity of nations giving thanks for 70 years of service.
I hope you don't mind, hope you don't mind that I put you down in words. How wonderful life is while you're in the world.
From every corner of the globe, Italian tenor Andrea Bocelli. Alicia Keys bathing Buckingham Palace in orange.
This girl is on fire. This girl is on fire.
Duran Duran with a nod to British fashion. And two musical legends brought the best of the West End. Messages from those who call Her Majesty friend.
I love you like many other people.
Your genuine warmth to our entire family.
A wholehearted thank you, ma'am.
Including one of her contemporaries, also 96, David Attenborough, shifting the focus.
The decisions we make today could lead to a brighter future.
Prince William using his speech to highlight the need to protect the planet.
As the Queen celebrates her Platinum Jubilee, the pressing need to protect and restore our planet has never been more urgent.
A night of many emotions, the main ones, respect and gratitude.
Your Majesty, Mummy.
As the Prince of Wales spoke movingly about his mother's dedication over 70 years.
You have met us and talked with us. You laugh and cry with us. And most importantly, you have been there for us for these 70 years.
And with the Queen watching from Windsor Castle.
So if we cheer loudly enough, she might might just hear us.
The Platinum Party at the Palace, Peking, with Diana Ross. The finale to a night the likes of which we've never seen and may never see again. In London, Airlie Walsh, Nine News.
And earlier in the day, Princess Anne stepped in for the Queen at the Epsom Derby, Her Majesty an avid horse lover watching the race from home at Windsor. The Cambridges also had a packed day visiting rehearsals for a Jubilee concert at Cardiff Castle, Princess Charlotte having a go at conducting an orchestra. Well, the UK is now waking up to the last day of Jubilee celebrations and it is set to be a spectacular finale. Our Europe correspondent Brett McLeod explains.
Well, how do you top the concert of a lifetime? In a few hours' time, they are going to try to do that here once again in the Mall. It'll be lined by tens of thousands of people and there'll be thousands of performers taking part in a pageant over 3 kilometres long with massive displays including a giant wedding cake, a huge Lady Godiva and a dragon the size of a double-decker bus floating towards Buckingham Palace. Ed Sheeran will wrap up the day with a special concert and then the hope is that the last person who'll be seen will be Her Majesty herself, standing on the balcony, and by her side, Princes Charles, William and George, the monarch and her successors.
Well, here in Melbourne, a small but passionate collection of royalists and expats have toasted Her Majesty, as Elizabeth Moss discovered, from pork pies to a parade of corgis, there was no shortage of reasons to celebrate.
Jack's proudly displayed, the windows lined with bunting. You'd be forgiven for thinking you're on the Mall, but this is a long way from Buckingham Palace. It's Dandenong, to be exact. Rob Boyle's butcher shop has everything you need for a Jubilee party. Everything British, that is.
I know we've sold over 1,000 pork pies. Over 1,000. All handmade. This is big. It's been massive. Biggest surprise how big it was.
From sausages to scotch eggs, trifle, even Bakewell tarts, in just 2 days he's made more than a week's worth of takings. That in itself worth celebrating. If you can't tell, Rob originally hails from Newark to be exact, and believe it or not, he hasn't been back since he moved here in the 80s. But that hasn't stopped him from getting into the festivities.
It lifts the mundaneness of everyday life. It just lifts people.
Spirits high in Malvern too. Toasting
the Queen.
The Queen, the longest serving monarch in British history.
For 70 years, I bet anybody watching this can't think of anyone else who's been doing the same job for 70 years and doing it so well.
And Flinders Street, a meet-up Her Majesty would definitely approve of. Dozens of corgis dolled up in their finest for the occasion.
A fleet of corgis.
At South Yarra, this chapel filled with the songs from her 1953 coronation service. In Sydney, former Prime Minister and UK Trade Advisor Tony Abbott attended a Jubilee church service. In Brisbane, it was high tea at the Botanic Gardens, with a few familiar faces too. Admittedly, close to 17,000 kilometres away from Windsor Castle, here it's safe to say opinions are divided.
Are you a fan of the royals?
Not really.
Not a royalist, no, but as soon as the corgis come out.
But of course, most Brits need little convincing.
The English do anything for a party, you know that.
And Elizabeth Moss is live for us at a very colourful Flinders Street station tonight. Lizzie, tributes are continuing.
They are, Alicia. The station itself, as you can see, bathed in that beautiful royal purple for the Platinum Jubilee. It's one of several landmarks across our city lit up tonight, including the MCG. Many of these places, of course, visited by Her Majesty when she was here. 1954, the station was decked out ahead of the royal visit, and a lot of people remember when the Queen boarded a tram here in the CBD. Now, this is far from the steps of the palace, but in Melbourne, you can't get a more beautiful tribute than this.
Very well said. Elizabeth Moss there, thank you.